Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. Have you ever wished you had a personal tutor at your beck and call, ready to guide you through the complexities of your studies? Well, the rapid advancement of artificial intelligence tools have made access to 24 hours a day, 7 days a week tutors a reality. But how good are they? In this video, I'm going to use an application called AI Tutor Pro to explore how AI tutors work, and whether they can help develop your understanding of subjects through an interactive and progressive learning process. Whilst I'm using AI Tutor Pro, that's been developed by a Canadian company called Contact Nord, who are a not-for-profit corporation, there are a number of other AI tutor applications that may offer similar functionality, so do feel free to explore these other applications. To use AI Tutor Pro, go to its website, and then you'll land on this page, and you can see that it has a really clean and simple interface. At the bottom of the webpage, it enables you to ask questions about any topic that you want to learn. Before you pose a question, make sure you tick the summary option. This is important, you'll see why later in the video. For our example, I'm going to type in here that I'd like to learn about the ethical uses of AI predictive models in social work. At this point, you can obviously choose any topic that you want to. The way AI Tutor then works is that it asks me a question, which is, what is one of the key ethical considerations when using AI predictive models in social work for assessing the risk of child abuse? To be honest, this is quite a complex question for a beginner. But if you are a beginner, don't be put off. I'll show you why later in the video. In response to this question about a key ethical consideration, I'm going to type that the data the predictions are based on are not biased. It responds by stating, correct, ensuring the data used by AI predictive models is not biased is crucial to prevent perpetuating or exacerbating existing inequalities or discriminations. It's essential to address and mitigate data biases to ensure fair and equitable use of AI in social work. My first impression is that, given my short answer, this is a slightly more detailed response than I expected, and helps to stretch my understanding by going into the areas of fairness and equity. These are also really important principles for social work practices in this field. At the bottom of its response, it poses the next question. This is how AI Tutor works. The next question asks, how can transparency in AI predictive models be maintained to ensure ethical use in social work? I like this because, to me, it feels like a logical next question, building on the previous one. It feels like an incremental development of my knowledge and learning. Now, I should respond by outlining two main arguments. These are that, one, access to data, and two, knowing how the predictive models work are both important. But what I'm going to do is leave out point two to see how it responds. So I type in, the user must have access to the data that the models making the predictions are based upon. Now, let's see if it picks up on the point that I've left out. It does indeed pick this up by responding. That's partially correct. Transparency can indeed be maintained by providing access to the data used by the models. But it's also important to ensure that the workings of the AI models themselves are understandable to the users. This includes having clear information on how the models make their predictions and what factors they consider. Ensuring transparency in this way can help build trust and allow for meaningful oversight by social workers and other stakeholders. Now, isn't this interesting? Because the response doesn't just assess my initial answer, but also addresses the missing element and provides an opportunity to extend my learning further by introducing the topics of building trust and oversight by social workers and other stakeholders using AI predictive models. So it's actually pushing the boundaries of my learning by moving beyond its original questions and my responses. As you can see, I had a back and forth with the AI tutor, and you can pause the video to explore the questions, my responses, and the feedback provided. To be honest, the questions being posed right from the beginning often felt quite complex. So, can the system work for beginners? Well, let's see how AI Tutor responds if I give an inaccurate answer to the following question? Why is it important to involve diverse stakeholders in the development and deployment of AI predictive models in social work? I'll respond by saying, it's not important to involve diverse stakeholders, which, as I said, is quite obviously the wrong answer. It responds by saying, actually, involving diverse stakeholders in the development and deployment of AI predictive models in social work is very important. Diverse stakeholder involvement ensures that a variety of perspectives, especially those of communities affected by the AI tools, are considered. This helps in designing models that are culturally sensitive, ethically aligned with the values of different groups, and more likely to address needs and concerns of a broad population. It also helps in identifying potential biases and reducing the risk of harm that AI systems might inadvertently cause due to a lack of understanding of certain community dynamics or issues. I mean, it doesn't tell me off for getting the answer wrong. Instead, it provides a detailed response that is instant, and I feel encouraging. It's not off-putting and keeps me engaged. So let's see how it responds if I don't know the answer to a question. The next question it poses is, how should the outcome of AI predictive model decisions be measured to ensure they are beneficial to clients in social work? I'm going to respond by saying, I don't know. Have a look at the response. Do you find this encouraging? I do. It states, that's okay. This is a complex issue. To ensure beneficial outcomes, the decisions made by AI predictive models in social work should be measured against specific, client-centered outcomes. These could include improvements in client well-being, successful interventions, reduction in reoccurrence of issues such as abuse or neglect, and overall enhancement in quality of services provided. It's also important to collect feedback from clients and social workers on the ground to help assess the real-world impact of these decisions. At any point, you can also use the Ask Me Another Question button here. And once you are finished, click the Done button. When you do this, the AI tutor will create a table with its questions, the correct answers, and your answers that you can copy and paste and save to review later. Remember that it does this because we ticked the summary option at the start. Having used AI Tutor, I have to be honest, I wish I had tools like this when I was a student. I think tools like this work well with experienced learners and those who are just starting their learning journeys. However, I did feel at times that some of the questions AI Tutor asked me could be potentially intimidating to new learners. But the responses to my wrong answers and the fact that I could simply say that I didn't know the answer would probably help build my confidence in using the tool. This is particularly true if the topic I was exploring was new to me. I found that this tool didn't provide me with the sources that its responses are based upon. So although I did like this tool, I would always say to the students that they double check the responses to ensure their accuracy. Also remember that as a student, you must always make sure that you seek guidance from your tutors about how and if you can use tools such as AI Tutor. I hope you enjoyed this short exploration of how AI tutors work. Do let me know how you find using AI tutors by leaving a comment below. I'd really enjoy hearing from you. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos on AI and education. If you want to learn more about generative AI tools for education, please check out this link. I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.